As we are more than just air duct cleaners, we're clean air specialists.
Have Zero Res air duct specialists out, and right now we'll give you $50 off your air duct cleaning, and while we're at it, we'll give you $50 off your dryer vent cleaning. Zero Res.
Spelled forward or backwards, it's the right way to clean. C-E-R-O-R-E-C.
Zero Res. Mueller Air Conditioning presents...
Are you cool?
Today's challenger, a corporate management manager from Jacksonville, Florida. Meet Les Blankston.
Yeah, hi, Bob.
That is a remarkably beige suit there, Les. Tell us, why are you on the show?
Well, I just replaced my old air conditioner with a new one from Bueller, and I'm just so comfortable these days. I wondered, am I cool now?
Let's find out, Les. Go ahead and spin the wheel.
That's right, Les. By upgrading your old AC to a more energy-efficient model from Bueller Air Conditioning, you'll save money, save energy, and proudly show your family that
you are cool.
Do you think I should get a mohawk?
Pace yourself, Les.
Stay cooler with Bueller.
Visit BuellerAir.com.
Start your Sunday off with a cup of Joe and some sports medicine intel. This is Joe C. inviting you to join me and Dr. George Barry for Breaking Bones every Sunday morning at 7:30. And if you miss an episode, just look for Breaking Bones wherever you listen to podcasts.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Scheinkopf, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with two decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
But I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it, and at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Scheinkopf leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. 904-274-5522.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
I don't practice Santeria. I ain't got no crystal ball. I had $1 million, but I'd spend it all.
So we were just discussing the mock draft that was put on by the Las Vegas radio station Raiders Nation Radio, which, Taylor, I'm actually kind of surprised that anyone that's a Raiders fan would ever invite me to be a part of anything.
I know, they obviously do not know who you are.
Correct. After I basically said Derek Carr was going to not be a good quarterback, and so far that's been right, but I wish him, you know, nothing but the best, sure. So I selected Brian Thomas Jr., the wide receiver out of LSU, who played opposite Malik Nabers with Jaden Daniels as quarterback, and a lot of people are excited about the speed that he has. He's a 4.33 guy. That's what he ran at the combine. And, of course, his size, too. 6'3", 209 pounds. That's a great big receiver for Trevor Lawrence. And, Taylor, you did a podcast on Brian Thomas Jr.
I did, yeah. His name, Preston Guy, he works for TigerBait.com. I was originally doing it on Jaden Daniels. This is when, because this is for my Bears podcast, but I was going through all the quarterbacks that the Bears could potentially take. This is pre-trade of Justin Fields. And in that, though, I was like, you can't ignore the weapons that they had in LSU, so let's talk about some of them. And as I was talking about Malik Nabers, he just kept mentioning Brian Thomas. And I was like, all right, you keep mentioning Brian Thomas, so we've got to go there. And he had some, they're different. Him and Nabers are very different. They do different things. They're better at different things. But I do have a clip of him kind of explaining his weaknesses and his strengths, but also how he could affect NFL teams.
Brian Thomas is a little less well-rounded. He's more of a deep ball threat.
Okay.
He's not going to run. He's not going to run as crisp as routes. He's a little, you know, more of a speed, less of a quick receiver. You know what I mean? He's not saying he's faster than Malik Nabers. He probably isn't as fast as him, but he's more of a straight line speed type guy who's going to have some mobility to make cuts, but he's a bigger receiver. He's a taller receiver, and he is a guy who's going to go up and get it a little bit better than Malik Nabers. Very sure-handed, especially toward the end of his careers, where Jaden Daniels was hitting him on a lot of these deep balls where he's having to catch him in stride on his fingertips, like without slowing down at all, because that was the kind of accuracy he was getting hit with. So he is a good receiver. I think he is going to be one of the bigger value picks in this draft. I expect both Malik and Jaden will be gone in the top 10. That might not be the case for Brian Thomas. He could be sticking around. He'll probably be more of a top 20 pick.
Yeah.
And I think a team, you know, a good team could get their hands on him. I mean, he'll make a good reward for them because, I mean, he's just a solid player, big-bodied guy, you know, receiver.
I like it. I like it a lot. And, again, if you missed it, yes, Jared Verse was still on the board in the scenario that I was given, as well as Terrion Arnold, the cornerback out of Alabama, but Quinion Mitchell had already been taken. I went with the receiver who I think is going to help Trevor Lawrence the most, and I did tell you that Tony Storm would be joining us in this segment. They are just now arriving, so we will have them on in just a few moments, so super excited to talk to Tony and her wrestling career at AEW.
And we, and a couple other housekeeping notes, we will have Matt Muscana of ESPN Baton Rouge on Thursday, so he'll break Brian Thomas down even more, since obviously he's not just the apple of Lauren's eye, he's the apple of a lot of Jaguar fans' eyes. Again, could the Jaguars go wide receiver at 17? It'll be curious to see if that is the route they take, whether they pick at 17 or if they trade back. A couple other notes. We did have a little issue with our YouTube live stream, so our YouTube chat line friends, we are back up and running. Just click the new link on the 1010XL video homepage, and if you have no idea what I'm talking about, Google 1010XL video, 1010XL, the home of the Jaguars, and then you'll be able to see our YouTube channel where we have even more in-depth insight with all of our podcasts and video programming to also learn more about Jaguars draft picks and, of course, watch whatever show is live, which currently that is us right here at HQ, Helmets and Heels. And you can get in on the chat as well. I wanted to read one chat from
one of our
first stream before we had to reset the stream. Thank you to Robert, if you're still listening, who wants to note that as a Penguins fan, they won back-to-back Stanley Cups. They haven't won a playoff series since. I am A-okay with that.
And that's my sentiment, is the joy that you get when your team reaches the mountaintop, especially if it's a team that you've loved your whole life, that you have family connections surrounding that team, and you've been through the pain of those losses. I mean, think of all the people, Taylor, in 2017, you included, who spent a lot of money to get to Jaguars postseason games and to fall short when you were leading the Patriots, but then to fall short in the AFC Championship game. I mean, to imagine then turning the tables, beating the Chiefs in the AFC Championship, going to the Super Bowl and actually winning it, like the tears that would flow, unlike the tears that may have flowed in 2017 when the Jags did lose.
Yeah, and when you do, you have that championship, especially in the modern era, when you talk about some of the teams who have their championships and you have to go like pre-Super Bowl, that's when it gets a little stretched. But I think that you want championships, and would it be great to be the Chiefs who get both, who get year after year of competitiveness, and even pre-Patrick Mahomes we're still winning 10, 11, 12 games, and then also get multiple Super Bowls? Yes, that's ideal, but it's very hard. You don't see that happen often. You've seen it with Tom Brady and the Patriots, and you've seen it with obviously what we're seeing now with Patrick Mahomes, but most of the time you see those – you see the Baltimore Ravens with Joe Flacco win the Super Bowl, and you have those little spurts, and I bet the Ravens wouldn't trade that for anything. They love that. And so, yeah, I think it's hard to give up any championships for – I get it. It's fun to win for a long time, but give me it all.
Yeah, give me it all. All right, Toni Storm has arrived. We will check in with her on the other side on Helmets and Heels on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Now hear this. Here's 1010XL's new line.
We're sending you back to the future.
Buckle up.
Dan and Jeff in the morning. Mike and Tony 10 to noon. Mia, Lauren and Taylor noon to 2. Joe, Matt and Leon 2 to 4. Frank and Hayes 4 to 6. And Rick and Hacker in the evening.
We invite you now to listen.
What makes a Honda certified pre-owned vehicle so special? 182-point inspection, 24/7 roadside assistance, first-year free oil changes, and a 7-year, 100,000-mile warranty for carefree driving backed by American Honda. Visit your local Honda dealer today.
Hey, sports fans, it's Hayes Carlion from MyBookie. Oh, it is here.
Masters Week, my favorite Tigers in the field. We've got the Live Golf guys playing in a major again. It is going to be a blast. If you haven't signed up for my bookie, you need to sign up. This is going to be must-see TV, and you can bet long odds for big golf sweats and even bigger cash. Outright winners, first-round leaders, and live betting too. I'm telling you, if you haven't signed up yet for my bookie, do it now for Masters Week. Could the weather in Augusta cause some chaos? Take advantage of that. Make some money. Even if the Masters has started, you can live bet with long odds through Sunday afternoon. Getting started is simple. Sign up today at MyBookie and use promo code 1010XL to secure a first deposit bonus up to 50%. It's simple. Just use promo code 1010XL to claim your 50% bonus, $50 minimum. Bet anything, anytime, anywhere with MyBookie.
Our slogan, Know Before You Blow, applies to more than just DUI cases. Hi, I'm attorney Lee Lockett of Lockett Law. Battery charges can result in jail time and criminal convictions too, so know before you blow a gasket and hit a loved one or a stranger. Drug crimes like possession of marijuana and cocaine will land you in cuffs too, so know before you blow. In a boating under the influence case, you also have the option to blow or not to blow. So know your options. Know before you blow. Go to knowbeforeyoublow.com now. Offices Jacksonville.
This date in sports history is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On April 9, 1950, during the 14th U.S. Masters Tournament, Jimmy DeMaria becomes the first three-time Masters champion, finishing two strokes ahead of Jim Ferrier.
Mark Watson with Hardball Creative. I know that hearing another ad for Jacksonville's best promo company interrupts Jacksonville's best sports talk, but at least it isn't a political ad. Check us out at HardballCreative.com.
Hardball Creative. Hardball does it all.
At Duck Duck Rooter, we understand plumbing issues can be a real inconvenience for your building or business, and we're here to help. We can handle all kinds of plumbing jobs, including broken pipes, clogged drains, line jetting, installing water heaters, and full repipes. Need a camera inspection or a smoke test? Yes, Duck Duck Rooter does that too. Plus, our lift station services include inspections, monitoring, cleaning, and repairs. When you're stuck, call the Duck. 904-862-6769. That's 904-862-6769.
Daily's Dash is not only your Jaguars game day stop, but a great place to grab a meal any day of the week. To honor the Jags and the fans, we've crafted the Duval Sub. The Duval comes with freshly sliced turkey, ham, melted cheddar, and habanero jack cheese, topped with crisp lettuce, fresh tomatoes, and a double portion of our secret sauce, all served on a fresh roll. Come by your local's Daily's Dash today to get your delicious Duval Sub. Daily's is the official convenience store sponsor of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Hey everybody, it's Mike Dempsey here for Pella Windows and Doors. Look, obviously the warmer temperatures are already here. And if you're like me, you want that oppressive Florida heat to stay outside your house. That's why I'm such a fan of Pella Windows and Doors. By now we know that windows are the number one way that heat gets in and the cold gets out. So when you're ready for the stylish design and energy efficiency that comes from Pella Windows and Doors, visit their showroom on Phillips Highway, just north of Bay Meadows, or you can always find them online at PellaJax.com. That's Pella Windows and Doors.
What's that sound? That's the sound of Downy Unstoppable scent beads going into your washing machine and giving your clothes freshness that lasts all day long. There it is again. It's like music to your ears, or more like music to your nose. That freshness is irresistible. Let's get a Downy Unstoppable bottle shake. And now a sniff solo. Nice. Get six times longer lasting freshness plus odor protection with Downy Unstoppables in wash scent beads.
Hello, sports fans. Hicken here. Let's talk skin. Iron Beach's Dermatology are reminding you to wear your sunscreen. If you're an active parent, hanging at the fields, in your boat to fish, or like to chill at the sandbar, wear sunscreen. But if you're the one that decided for years it's not cool, guess what? Cancer isn't cool either. So when grabbing the clubs for your tee time, gassing up the boat, or grabbing the chairs for your kids' games, make sure you bring the screen. Any concerns now? Give Beaches Dermatology a call online at BeachesDermatology.com.
Want to play golf and help raise some money for scholarships at the same time? Join the Clay County Gator Club at their 24th annual scholarship golf tournament presented by Walker Footings, Sunday, April 21st. To register, go to ClayGators.com.
You're shriveling up.
Jumbo Shrimp Baseball presented by FIS is home this week at 1-1 Financial Ballpark. Tonight is 70s night, followed by a new day game on ViStar Good is Everywhere Wednesday. The weekend starts with Coors Light Thirsty Thursday. Enjoy fireworks Friday and Saturday. Baseball all weekend with tickets starting at just $5. Log on to jackshrimp.com for tickets. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball. Affordable, family fun.
Toe 10XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Back to Helmets and Heels, and our next guest now joining us in studio, Timeless Tony Storm of AEW. Does this sound familiar to you?
Very familiar.
Yeah.
Now I'm on edge.
Yeah.
Do you need me to fight someone?
That is because it is her intro. That is her open on AEW, which will be returning to Daily's Place in April, which we are in April, the 20th. I'm making sure I got the right date. 24th, 25th. Or 23rd, 24th.
24, 27.
24 yeah, and 27. The Wednesday and the Saturday. And that is, of course, NFL draft week. So if you're trying to file away, it'll be that Wednesday before the draft kicks off. What better way to kick it off than with the folks of AEW, including Timeless Tony Storm, expected to play a major role in that show as well as the pay-per-view the Saturday previously in St. Louis. How are you? Welcome to 1010XL Studios.
I'm fantastic. How are you, ladies?
Doing well and excited to hear about what you guys have planned for the shows here in Duval later in the month. But first, let's kind of start with your journey. We were getting to know you a little bit off the air before we returned, and knowing your journey from Australia to New Zealand, back or New Zealand to Australia, I should say, then to the UK, here to the US. But I want to go back to when you were 10 years old. And that was when you first discovered wrestling.
Yes.
You self-admitted are not a sports fan, but you found wrestling how?
Well, right on the television, there it was. Couldn't take my eyes away. I saw the Hardy Boys. I thought, oh, dear God. Look at all this drama. Look, that I am drama. I'm going to do this one day. And I have. So it's great.
So you were 13 when you got really serious about wrestling, is that right?
I started training, yeah.
Okay, and what does training include for people who have never done any sort of wrestling, which is including me?
Well, it's really very stupid. You turn up to a class and you batter your own body for the sake of entertainment. And yeah, the rest is history.
And have you had serious injuries along the way since you've been doing this for so long?
I've had a few, yeah, nothing, well, okay, touch wood, nothing serious.
Okay.
But, I mean, I've been in pain for the past 15 years, and it's not, I don't think it's
me
going
too,
anywhere.
Me too, and I don't wrestle, so.
So you can imagine.
But you're not a sports fan, so is it, you know, are you out there like Rocky Balboa, like running the streets of Liverpool? Are you lifting? Is it a physical, is it a physical training, or is it more of the dramatic, more of the theater that you had to train in?
Well, it's, I'd say it's a good mix of both. Yes, there's definitely a big physical component to it. I've spent my life training, lifting weights, running around like a crazy person, trying to get in shape. I'll let you know when I get there. Mm-hmm. And yeah, and then of course there's the whole drama side to it, which is just as exhausting. It's it's the best of both worlds.
Was there a certain show event that you feel like really put you onto the map where you were like, okay, I'm here, I've made it?
Ooh, the night that I stepped foot in the ring for the very first time, mm-hmm. That was the one. And then because I knew that from here on out, I would be a success. And of course, I was.
Of course. Watching, for people watching on our YouTube, there is a massive belt here, yes. Massive AEW championship belt. What was that moment like when that was handed to you?
I mean, I thought, well, it's about time.
I love that.
Now it's around the waist of the rightful holder.
I
yeah.
That's confidence, and I love
thought,
it.
Finally, yes, is there anyone better? No, if not me, then who else?
So Timeless Tony Storm joining us in studio, and you joined AEW, which will be returning to Daily's Place April 23rd. I'm going to get the date
24.
Down.
24.
I swear I'm going to get I don't know what day of the week it is. I think it's Wednesday. But
people can go to Daly's Place the 24th for AEW, the 25th for the draft party.
Yes.
And then back on the 27th for
more There we
event.
Go. Numbers. It's hard.
Stay the week.
Speaking of numbers, you actually joined AEW in 2022, began your career here in the States with WWE. What led to, number one, signing with WWE? And then secondly, why the switch to AEW?
Oh, where do I begin? My journey with WWE began, I would say, around 2017. Mm-hmm. There was a tournament called the Mae Young Classic. I did two of those, and I got signed off the back of those. Well, they were running a UK brand at the time, so I was still in the UK, so I got going with them over there, and then was moved out to the United States and worked for WWE for a little while, and then got to a certain point where it was time to do something else, and I landed on my feet in AEW, and it's been fantastic ever since. Yeah, it really has. I've definitely found a home here in AEW.
I try explaining it to people all the time that, like, Tony Khan doesn't sleep because AEW, yeah, he does not, because AEW doesn't sleep. And we were just talking about it off the air. You guys, shows on Wednesday, shows on Saturday. How do you, I guess, two-parter again, but what is the best part of all that travel? What is the worst part of all that travel?
Oh, I mean, I would say the best part is you do get to see a lot of places with all your friends and have a wonderful time. But, I mean, it has its, you know, you will never sleep. Tony Khan doesn't sleep. I've never seen him stand still long enough for me to actually get a good look of him. He's just running around. It's not just wrestling as well. He has just a multitude of things he does, and I don't know how he does it. I don't know how he does it, and I tell you, he's never missed a single event
right.
at All Elite Wrestling. He is there every single time, and I it's inspirational. I don't know how to keep up with that, but I'm trying.
I know he takes his coffee from fetching his coffee once here at 1010XL headquarters. He takes his coffee black with sugar. Is that the secret sauce? Is that what you have in your coffee cup right now? Or?
Something like that.
Okay. Yes. There we go.
I did take a sip from his coffee at a media conference one time. And you're right. It is indeed coffee. How boring. How boring, I thought, oh, yep, not even sugar. I don't even think there was sugar in it.
No, it's like barely a little bit because I filled his coffee cup and I put creamer in it and he was like, oh, no,
no
Mia.
Cream.
I only do black coffee. And I was just like, you don't sleep. Like, how is this possible?
That's how. He just drinks black coffee.
Don't know how he does it.
Tony, one of the things we talk about a lot here are women in sports and women empowerment. And we talk about this belt here, but three-time champion you are. And so how is that holding the expectations of just kind of being almost the face for women wrestling right now, too?
I mean, it's a lot of pressure, but I'm the best one for the job.
There you go.
It's a hard old world out there for us women, and I will stop at nothing to elevate this wonderful women's division that we have, and I see no better way of doing that than having me right at the forefront of it as the most successful women in all of professional wrestling.
I think that's fantastic. Tony, when you look back at your career, what is or who are the people that have really stood out to you as far as helping you get to where you are today?
You know, I can't say there's been many. I have really done it all myself, done it all alone. I don't have many people to thank. Maybe Tony Khan.
Maybe.
But yes, people ask me who inspired you, and I say, yeah. Well, nobody. But I can say that there's probably a lot of women out there that would say me. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't get inspired. I inspire.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Interesting.
Yes.
I like that. Which another part of this wrestling evolution, for those who may not be familiar with AEW and the world of professional wrestling, is that you evolve. And so Timeless Toni Storm is a new identity you took on to reclaim the belt. Walk us through the development of character when it comes to professional wrestling.
Well, I've got to be honest with you. I haven't changed, and I always say this, everyone else has. I was this all along. This is who I've always been. I've done a few different acts along the way. I did a rock star act. I've done a few different little things, but this is the true me. I wanted to just give people my true self, and this is what it is. And it feels good to not have to hide it anymore. This is who I truly am. This is who I truly have always been. We live in a wonderful time where we finally get to see my true self.
Outstanding.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, so April 24th, April 27th, and people can go to dailiesplace.com. They can get tickets. Tell them why they should come watch you.
Yeah, we heard there's some drama.
Oh, there's going to be drama. Well, a few days before our events in Jacksonville, there's a pay-per-view taking place. It's called Dynasty, and I am defending the championship against my arch nemesis, Thunder Rosa. I don't have to tell you too much about her, because she is a horrible old cow. And let me tell you, I will be marching into Daly's Place in Jacksonville, still the AEW Women's World Champion. She will not get her greasy little mitts anywhere near it. So it's going to be a celebration like no other. Whether it's Dynamite on the 24th or Coliseum on the 27th, it's going to be all-out action, all-out drama. You'll get to see me. I don't know what I'm going to be doing yet, but I can tell you it's going to be spectacular as always. It's going to be a hell of an affair. It is the home, the birthplace of All Elite Wrestling, so everyone is going to be at the top of their game. Everyone's going to be as excited as ever. It's going to be a huge event, not to be missed. It's got to be fantastic.
I love it. Does Thunder Rosa have thunder thighs?
Yes. Yes, she does. Oh, I could say a lot about that woman. I could. But it's fine because you, the locals of Jacksonville, will not have to worry. They will not be seeing her at Daly's Place because I will eviscerate her prior to getting there.
Before she even gets in the ring.
Yes, she would. I told the travel department, don't book her a flight. She won't need it. She won't make it.
We're leaving her in St. Louis.
She's staying in St. Louis. She is now a resident of St. Louis. She is not going anywhere. She's done.
The Jacksonville Jaguars are not going anywhere, and neither is AEW and Timeless Toni Storm. Thank you so much for taking the time to stop by and stopping by HQ. Yes. And again, it is April 24th,
27th.
Wednesday, April 27th, Saturday, Daly's Place. You can get tickets online
at dailiesplace.com.
There it is. Timeless Toni Storm. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much, darlings.
From New Zealand, Australia, a worldly gal, and of course, a world champion with AEW. Helmets and Heels continues after this.
Once upon a time, there was no sports radio.
You like an answer to our prayers?
No, I mean, wait a minute. I'm not an answer to your prayers. I'm not a savior or Martin Luther King or the Easter Bunny.
1010XL.
That's all.
Jacksonville Sports Radio.
After consulting with several orthopedic specialists about my constant knee pain, I chose Southeast Orthopedic Specialist and Dr. Chris Swanson to handle my surgery. Their professionalism let me know this team was the one for me. The surgery was very successful, and if I ever have a future knee, I'll continue to trust Southeast Orthopedic Specialists to take care of me.
Relieve pain and get back to life.
SOS.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
Transmission troubles? I'm Robin Sidbury, owner of Action Transmission Specialist on Merrill Road. So come in and see how we can help solve your transmission troubles. We service all makes and models. Remember, get traction. Call Action at 744-0755.
What's changed totally inside and out? The Kuhn Flowers massive storefront, and yes, they've totally remodeled the showroom inside too. This is Frank Frangie, and the next time you drive by, stop and smell the roses at Kuhn Flowers.
WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
Your cooling system isn't working. Maybe somebody showed up with a portable electronic device. Then they discussed with you what your options are. Maybe they gave you an estimate that seems like an awful lot of money. What's the smart thing to do? When the situation merits a second opinion, get a Mike Merritt opinion. Yes, the Mike Merritt Comfort Team shows up with hand tools. We've never been able to fix an air conditioning problem with a tablet. Mike Merritt has been the trusted name for more than 30 years because there's never any hocus pocus. The Merritt team will walk you through the diagnostic steps up close and personal and show you exactly what you need. And the Mike Merritt price is likely to be far less because there's never an overtime charge and the Merritt team doesn't work on commission. So remember, when it comes to the health of your cooling system, a second opinion can only help, and a Mike Merritt opinion can save you money. Florida license CACO 50384.
It's the Guggen Open.
Let's play some golf.
Listen to the drill for your chance to play in this year's Coastal Equipment Guggen Open.
Hey, so where do we tee off?
April 15th at Hidden Hills Golf Club.
Four.
Breakfast provided by Chick-fil-A. Enjoy a box lunch from Dandy Foods. Pick up a cigar from Tobacco Cove.
You can do this.
Win great prizes on the course from Edwin Watts Golf.
Thanks to our sponsors,
Andy's Automotive, CSS Outdoor, the Plumbers and Pipe Fitters Union 234, Royal Pest Control, and Injury Care Centers.
Let Hodges Mazda find the perfect Mazda SUV just for you. Lauren Brooks here. Transition from city streets to off-road trails in a newly leased 2024 Mazda CX-50 for only $316 a month, or lease the stunning 5-passenger 2024 Mazda CX-30 for only $298 a month. Our professional non-commissioned sales team always puts your best interests first. Plus, every vehicle purchase comes with 2 years free maintenance. Visit Hodges Mazda today or shop online at HodgesMazda.com for the Hodges Mazda difference. See dealer for details. Lease, terms, and fees for qualified applicants expires April 30th, 2024.
Hacker here with another unbelievable stat. I'm now down 45 pounds in just 6 weeks with Awaken 180 weight loss. 45 pounds, and I basically just started the program. I wasn't always this walking advertisement for feeling good. Let's just say the struggle was real. Tried everything. Programs, diets, and yes, even those injections. Sure, I lost a few pounds, but the results were so slow. Top that with not feeling myself, coupled with needing shots for the rest of my life? No thanks. Thank you. It's not just the 45-pound number. Even though, yeah, that's unbelievable. It's about life, man. I took a little hack to SeaWorld last week. Walked around all day, no sweat, no being tired. 2 months ago, I would have skipped out on that whole experience. If it's time for you to drop some weight like it was for me, do what I did. Go to awaken180weightloss.com or call 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800. It's Awaken 180 Weight Loss.
This is Molly McDonald with your 1010XL Southeast Orthopedic Specialist Local Sports Update. UConn defends their title as the 2024 NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament champions, beating Purdue 75-60. UConn becomes the first school to win back-to-back titles since Florida in 2007. The Florida Gators are back on the field tonight down in Tallahassee, battling against in-state rival the Seminoles for the third and final time this season. First pitch at 7 o'clock. Listen to the game live on 1010 AM. Ahead of their orange and blue game, head coach Billy Napier spoke on the momentum leading up to the Gator spring game.
The theme is momentum, and I think we've got that. We got to keep it this week and kind of finish this first half of the offseason, you know, 1 week from today with the orange and blue game.
It's 79 degrees at 1 o'clock. Time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
Ready? In 3, 2, 1.
The countdown to the draft is on.
I hope you're ready.
Who'll be off the board when the Jaguars pick? Let's find out.
That noise can only mean one thing, ladies. It's time to continue our countdown to number 17, that all-important 17th overall pick that your Jacksonville Jaguars currently hold. We are at number 5, which means it's time to check in on the Los Angeles Chargers. Shannon Farron joins us now on the All-Pro Roofing Hotline from Los Angeles, the host or co-host, I should say, of the Gary and Shannon Show. You can catch it 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. weekdays on KFI AM 640. Good morning. How are you doing, Shannon?
Good morning, girls. I am doing great. It's very exciting leading up to the draft. It's like there is no off season anymore.
That is for sure, and it's an exciting time out there in Southern California. Before we ask you where you believe the Chargers are leaning with that fifth overall pick, we got to start big picture. We got to start with the headlines that the Los Angeles Chargers made this offseason, including perhaps the biggest splash of the offseason, inking Jim Harbaugh to become their next head coach. Walk me through the vibes of the demise of the Brandon Staley era to where we are now with Jim Harbaugh set to return to the National Football League.
It was a slog. I'm not going to lie to you. Trying to see if Brandon Staley would materialize some victories, some more playoff appearances for the LA Chargers. And it, according to all of us that have watched the past 3 or 4 years, it just seemed like, although the intentions were great on defense, maybe he tried to do too much. The assignments were confusing. There was no back to basics type of mentality. He really believed in his defensive philosophy, and you got to hand that to him, to stick to his guns. Unfortunately, it just didn't work out. There was a lot of missed assignments. The secondary was pretty thin. I'll say that they were smaller. But the thing with Jim Harbaugh, what he brings, I mean, he brings a bouquet of wonderful attributes to this team and this game. We all know what he's been able to do all throughout his career at Stanford, at San Diego, with the 49ers, with Michigan, bringing that national championship there. And he just knows how to get players motivated. And he really does have a back-to-basics mentality that is really going to benefit this Chargers team. He is very into having a physical team. This is new for San Diego, or for Los Angeles. What was San Diego? When they were in San Diego, that was always kind of the knock on them, right? That they were smaller. Jim Harbaugh is going to make a big physical, hit you right in the mouth game team here.
It's funny, Shannon, we call them the San Diego Chargers of Los Angeles around here because so many of us end up saying San Diego first because obviously of all the years and the history there. All right, so here in Jacksonville, we talk a lot about Trevor Lawrence, as every franchise quarterback is always going to be scrutinized. What are the feelings on Justin Herbert out there in L.A.?
The feelings are great. Justin Herbert has every throw. He can make every throw. The importance that they're focusing on right now is the run game, establishing the run game so that Justin Herbert doesn't have to do too much, and also keeping him healthy. Jim Harbaugh brought in a bunch of his staff from Michigan to keep these guys healthy and to protect Justin Herbert and protect that arm. If you establish the run game, as we all know, it opens them up to do the magic that Justin Herbert is known to do. I think everybody has 110, if not more, percent confidence in Justin Herbert leading this team back to the playoffs.
Yeah, Shannon, I think one of the things that may lead to some of the decisions that are going to be made with the Chargers when it comes to this year's draft, but this offseason was interesting for you guys offensively. Obviously, Keenan Allen, Mike Williams, Austin Eckler all went elsewhere. A big portion of what that offense has been recently. So what are the thoughts on that, and how quickly the Chargers and Chargers fans and media believe they can rebuild? And is that kind of dictating where they're going for this draft?
That is the million-dollar question that you asked from Jacksonville that we're all talking about here in Los Angeles, is what to do with that wide receiver room. It has been decimated with Mike Williams leaving, Keenan Allen going to Chicago. It's a big question. And Jim Harbaugh said the quiet part out loud just this week, saying, yeah, I'm excited to see that. just calling the wide receiver room that in his comments. Now, the good thing is at number 5, it looks like it's quite possible that the first 4 picks will be quarterbacks, which, as Jim Harbaugh pointed out, really means that the Los Angeles Chargers have the number 1 pick when it comes to the best wide receiver on the board.
To your point, Shannon, we had an Arizona Cardinals reporter join us yesterday, and he believes that the pick will be traded at number 4 for a team looking for a quarterback. And so, without further ado, the Los Angeles Chargers with the 17th overall pick in the 2024
fifth overall pick.
Wow, I was stuck on the 4. Thank you. Good call. With the 5th overall pick in the 2024 NFL draft, select.
I would say Donovan Mitchell from Texas.
Wow.
Or offensive tackle J.C. Latham.
Wow.
I think that they want to focus on that offensive line and making that solid. But like we have talked about, there's no doubt about them needing a superstar wide receiver. Quentin Johnson came out last year. He was supposed to be the rookie of the year, and that did not materialize for whatever reason. Sometimes wide receivers don't come out of the draft and put on a show in their rookie year. Sometimes there is a learning curve, even at that position. So they're expecting big things from Q this year, but I would be kind of surprised if they didn't pick a wide receiver at 5.
Do you think the Chargers are in the trade back market?
You know, it's interesting because we have a new GM. Tom Telesco, that was not the way he operated. And who knows what this new GM is going to do. We know that he has talked about moving away from the philosophy that you saw for so many years of them not making a big trade mid-season. And he's completely turned that philosophy on his head and said, we're going to do whatever we can throughout the entire season to make sure we have the best team possible at every point.
Whoa, Shannon, let's not bury the lead here. Yeah. If we're going four quarterbacks, Marvin Harrison Jr.'s on the board, Roma Dunze's on the board, Malik Nabers is on the board, and you believe that Jim Harbaugh will zig when everyone else would have zagged with that fifth overall pick?
I have no idea what Jim Harbaugh is going to do. I love Nabers. I love those guys you just mentioned. Jim Harbaugh doesn't eat chicken because it's a nervous animal. Jim Harbaugh is crazy. Like, this is a certifiable guy, which is why the players love him so much, right? So I have no idea what his pick's going to be. I have no idea what the mentality of the GM is. They're kind of holding their cards close to the vest at this point in terms of who they like. So I think, you know, all we can do is speculate. That's our jobs.
Yeah.
So it won't be a surprise to me if it's a surprise pick, if it's not the names you're talking about. Marvin Harrison Jr., of course, getting all of the publicity.
I do want to ask you, because that was, as we mentioned, just the offense for the Chargers and the changes that they've kind of came across this last offseason. How do people feel about that? Because they did find ways to keep Khalil Mack and Joey Bosa, but the entire offense surrounding Justin Herbert has kind of been pushed away and traded. How are the thoughts about that in kind of abandoning almost your QB1?
Yeah, I mean, we've all seen the memes of the Chargers taking away all of Justin Herbert's weapons. The run game is going to be key, as I mentioned. They're going to have to build up that room with the absence of Austin Eckler, who, frankly, did not produce as much last season as we had known him to produce. They've brought in a couple fullbacks to the point of making it a physical team, couple tight ends, big guys there at that position. We'll have to see what they fortify that offense with. There are a lot of questions in terms of how much they'll be able to do with guys ready to go, plug-and-play guys out of the draft. But, yeah, I mean, it's certainly a question. The best thing I can say to that is it's Justin Herbert, mm-hmm. and he can make do with not a lot. As long as you protect him, you know, as long as you fortify that O-line to where it was when Corey Linsley was there, Rashawn Slater wasn't injured. He had to deal with that last year, and it was frankly a mess.
Would anyone be surprised if Jim Harbaugh selected a running back fifth overall? Maybe even the tight end Brock Bowers. I know there's been plenty of smoke about that as well, Shannon.
Like I said, I wouldn't be surprised by that. I wouldn't be surprised by anything Jim Harbaugh does.
ain't that the truth? You could catch her weekdays. That's 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Pacific time. Shannon Farron joining us on the All-Pro Roofing Hotline. She is on KFI AM 640 with Gary Hoffman. Again, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Pacific time. And thank you so much for breaking down all things Chargers as we look ahead to the NFL draft, Shannon.
Ladies, it was a pleasure. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you so much. And again, that is Shannon Farron. You can find her and Gary on Twitter at Gary and Shannon, on Instagram as well at Gary and Shannon. And thanks to Shannon for joining us.
So that was really interesting. As soon as she said Adonai Mitchell out of Texas or J.C. Latham out of Alabama, we all just stopped dead in our tracks and we're like, wait, what? Now, like we've discussed, Taylor, maybe Shannon was thinking, because there's been so much conversation about the Chargers trading back and trading with the Vikings, because the Vikings, of course, want a quarterback, and the Chargers have theirs. So maybe that's what she was thinking. Or maybe those are the conversations happening in Los Angeles, that they might like A.D. Mitchell ahead of other receivers. We also are not telling our guests who has been selected ahead of them, because we're not really trying to make them make a pick. We just want them to talk about who are some different targets for them. But if the Chargers went either Latham or Mitchell, I think, like we talked about yesterday, we love chaos in the draft.
Oh, my gosh.
That would send the draft into a little bit of chaos because Marvin Harrison Jr. would be, I feel like he would be super upset.
Yes. Marvin Harrison Jr. would be upset, but the Giants, Titans, Falcons, Bears, Jets, Vikings
would be thrilled.
Would be pretty happy. My guess is that Chargers talk is that they are probably going to trade back. But it is interesting to me because I feel like if I was Justin Herbert, I would be kind of mad right now. You had, and she mentioned in this where she was like, but, you know, it's Justin Herbert and he can do whatever How do we know that? Because since he's been there, he's had weapons and he hasn't had to really, like, Mike Williams has been one of the best. Keenan Allen obviously has been one of the best. And then also when you have guys like Austin Eckler who can kind of do a little bit of everything, Gerald Everett, like he's had guys since he's been there. So it's interesting to me that I don't know if we really know if he can without a bunch of help around him. And yes, offensive line, obviously he's had injury issues. He played a whole year almost with broken ribs, and we saw that here in Jacksonville. But I think that if I was Herbert, I'd be kind of upset because they made sure to restructure and do certain things to keep Khalil Mack and Joey Bosa, but get rid of everybody he has offensively and then possibly trade back and not get one of those top three wide receivers. And yeah, maybe they do get an AD who some people are really high on, but you have the potential to get Marvin Harrison Jr. at that point and give him to Justin Herbert. And honestly, Brock Bowers too, that's one of the ones that I think would fit perfect because Everett got sent to Chicago. And so now they're tied in. When you look at their weapons there, they have Gus Edwards as their running back, which I guess they want to bulk up their running back fullback room. I don't know what that means. But
bring back the fullback.
With everyone talking about Trent Baalke wanting to develop a physical identity, LOL, his former coworker tried to do the same in SoCal.
Jim Harbaugh's like, let's bring the aggressiveness back on the offense when we have Justin Herbert who can launch the ball down the field as far as you want and wherever you want. But Joshua Palmer, Quentin Johnston, which she said they had higher expectations for than they did. I remember I actually liked Quentin Johnston a lot last season. Darius Davis, Will Disley, and Hayden Hurst are their two tight ends. And then fullback, yeah, Ben Mason. So when you look, very underwhelming offensive room right now going from what they've had in the last few years.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see as this draft, as we near to it, how many more trades we start to hear about, because this is the time where you're going to start to see, okay, I'm hearing, you know, mm-hmm. whether it's a Rappaport or a Schefter, I'm hearing this team is interested in moving up or this team is interested in moving down.
Yeah, and I see everyone clamoring on Twitter now. Look, I'm telling you that's what I was told multiple people is an inkling that the Jaguars, again, wide receiver is high on the priority list. With the 17th overall pick, the 48th overall pick. Deep breaths. I know this gets you all very excited because a wide receiver in the first round to the Jaguars, Trent Baalke drafting a wide receiver in the first round, almost as rare as a Big Ten team winning a national title in men's or women's basketball.
Yeah.
So I understand. Deep breaths. Again, there is still a lot going on. We've seen a lot of defensive players who are presumed top 25 picks come through the Miller Electric Center this week. Another one, today, Troy Fatanu reportedly is visiting with the Jacksonville Jaguars. I don't see a world in which they go offensive line at 17 unless, again, it's a Joe Alt, maybe Fatanu, but I honestly don't see it happening, to be quite frank with you.
Definitely not a Mims.
I mean,
there's just so much work to be done with him still.
Right.
He's like not even close to a complete
product. Right.
That's what would scare me.
And would you pick that at 17?
No.
The answer is no. And so that's where, you know.
Marius Mims out of Georgia.
Yeah. Correct. Although the pro day for Georgia is still coming up.
Mm-hmm.
And that will be one to watch. And to that same point, Taylor, that's why I brought up in the 12 o'clock hour the notion of trading back to acquire capital to, I understand you did it last year and Trent Baalke couldn't trade back up. You trade back up because if you were to address wide receiver and defensive mm-hmm. back with your first two picks, then to get in that edge rusher mix, once you get to like pick 100, which is the last pick of day two, which I believe Jonah Ellis of Utah could be gone by then, it is a steep cliff.
Yeah.
from guys who would be plug and play versus projects. And there's nothing wrong with a project if you have Josh Allen under a long-term contract, if you have Trayvon Walker and Travis Gibson, for what it's worth, when Bill Shuey was his outside linebackers coach, had 7 sacks 3 years ago and then was cast into a defense that wasn't best suited for his skill set.
Mm-hmm.
And so I don't think it's a desperate position, but that is where, to your point about Marius Mims being a project, I don't see a project being selected at 17 I could see the gamble of you trade up from 96 to like 75, mm-hmm. and a guy like who Jeremy Fowler just reported is in the building right now, Jalex Hunt, the Houston Christian edge rusher that a lot of people think very exciting, tantalizing, top three in several different events at the Combine a few weeks ago. Do you say if we're getting our plug-and-play wide receiver, our plug-and-play corner with the first two picks, mm-hmm. can we then take that edge rusher who is a project? Versus do you say, well, we need the edge rusher depth right now, so we need a surefire project at 17?
I think, that's the question. What do they view their needs as far as the priorities? Is it offensive line? Because, again, Trevor Lawrence was banged up so much last year, and Trevor might have asked for a better offensive line moving forward. And the only real acquisition that they made was getting Mitch Morse. Yes, because Ezra Cleveland was already here at the end of last season, even though he was banged up when he got here. But is that what they are leaning towards, is more let's add another tackle because the future of Cam Robinson and all those things, not necessarily at 17, but early in the draft? Or do they view, yes, the corner need, the receiver need, and edge rush because the depth there, you're going to get a starter with the receiver in the corner, mm-hmm. is what we all believe.
Yeah.
The edge, that player is probably not starting unless there's a whole shift in the defense and Trevon Walker gets placed in the interior. I don't necessarily foresee that happening because of how he's been trained to this point in time. But that's what we will find out as the draft goes on. We all assumed last year that they'd be drafting the edge rush depth because they didn't sign one in free agency.
And they had half of their top 30 visits were edge rushers.
Right.
And then it was linebackers.
Yeah. And then to just add Yasir Abdullah, which maybe he turns out to be a great player. Yeah. Pete Prisco was always high on him, had him on his better than team. But either way, let's get it to some Mia's mock draft. These are released on Mondays. Who do you have at 17 in this iteration?
Yes, this week's mock draft 2.0, which you can find on 1010XL.com. Just scroll down to the Jaguars blog. Click on that. It'll be the first headline for this week. Last I checked, at least, it was the first most updated post on our Jaguars blog.
You can also get there from the main page from the Mia's mock draft flash banner, too.
Yes, you can also get there that way. And, of course, the video version live on our 1010XL channels. With the 17th overall pick, I have the Jacksonville Jaguars trading back to 26th overall with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Hey, now listen, again, this
is 26th?
Yes, we are going to have four versions of Mia's Mock Draft Monday. So mm-hmm. maybe they trade up next week. Mm-hmm. In this scenario, they trade back.
Stressed.
They trade back.
Taylor's sweating.
They trade back to 26th overall and select Kool-Aid McKinstry, cornerback, Alabama. Now, that trade, the value, which I did run through the draft value chart, mm-hmm. so this is accurate. The Bucs would get pick 17 and number 153, that's the Jaguars' fifth rounder, mm-hmm. in exchange for the 26th overall pick and two third rounders, because the Bucs have three third rounders late on day two. And so the Jaguars get number 26, number 89, and number 92. They select Kool-Aid McKinstry, who, of course, they had in the building last week for a visit. They met with him at the Combine as well. There is clearly interest between Ryan Nielsen, Trent Baalke, and the Alabama corner, who I understand people have concerns about the Jones fracture. I have now spoken to multiple orthopedic surgeons. There is really no reason to be concerned about this Jones fracture. Again, he ran a 4.47 with the Jones fracture at his pro day. It has now been corrected. And he's expected to be ready for, I believe, OTAs, and if not, training camp. So I don't think he's going to miss a beat. Proven veteran defensive guy for Alabama. Plug and play, cornerback position, check off the list.
And Taylor, do you add rum or vodka or tequila to Kool-Aid? What would be the drink that would then
Kool-Aid.
Become...
I'll put vodka in there.
Vodka? Okay. Yeah.
With the 48th
moving along.
With the 48th overall pick, the Jacksonville Jaguars select Ricky Pearsall, wide receiver, Florida. And for what it's worth, ladies, I have heard that Ricky could go anywhere between 28
the end of the first round.
And 60.
Yeah, he's been one of the highest risers when it comes to moving up draft boards. Since the end of the season and this offseason process, Ricky Pearsall, as someone who watched him the last 2 years every snap, he can make the contested catches. He finds the middle of the field super well, so he's much more of a slot guy than an outside receiver, which is why I think a lot of people would be like, well, you already have Christian Kirk. Why do that? But I think they're both versatile enough receivers, and he's got a good size. Got to talk to him at SEC Media Days last summer and came away super impressed, was super professional, and loves the game of football.
And I believe he does have inside-outside versatility, similar to Kirk. I don't think he's going to be a burner downfield or anything like that, or a bigger-bodied guy like a Gabe Davis where he's blocking the A-gap or something like that coming around the middle, because that's what Gabe said in his introductory presser, that he would do literally anything.
Well, he's a Swiss Army knife, in Doug's words.
Yes, exactly. There it is. I don't believe that that's what Pearsall provides you, but the catch radius, because the one-handed grabs we love, but also the percentile in terms of drops versus catch. That's where I look at Ricky Pearsall. I look at what has plagued this Jaguars wide receiver room for years. He caught 65 of 67 catchable passes in 2023. That's a 97% mark. And that was, with all due respect to Graham Mertz, with an offensive operation that had a lot of question marks. And so
the offensive line had question marks. Mertz was pretty accurate.
Right. But again, knowing all the other issues at hand, the fact that he was able to put a season together where he had over 900 receiving yards, for me, that says, hey, he's doing more with less at the college level. And so often when you look at the NFL draft, because you want to draft the best players who are on the best teams, because those usually translate to the National Football League, there's question marks if a guy's on a team that maybe wasn't a Washington or a Texas in the national in the college football playoff.
Yeah, and by the way, one other thing, I picked Brian Thomas Jr. in a mock draft yesterday, and when I forgot to mention, he had 17 receiving touchdowns this season that led the nation. And get this, that was one in every four catches he caught a touchdown pass.
Yeah. And that's also a saucy nug, by the way, RJ. Be ready for that saucy nug. We got a lot of them coming.
That's also on a team that had Malik Nabers, who was doing the same type of production on that offense. And that's one of the things when I talked to the guy about Brian Thomas, he was like, we talk so much about Malik Nabers, but what Brian Thomas was able to do with and still produce with somebody who was doing the amount of production he had, but that also he was giving a lot of love to Jaden Daniels, too. One thing I think, and I know we got to go to break, but one of the things that I do think that we should talk about a bit more, too, of what could possibly open up the Jags offense, and I don't feel like we've talked about it a ton, is figuring out the run game. And I know the offensive line was a big part of that, but that I just think would also open more opportunities for other things, because they were terrible last year when it came to running the ball. A stat literally just popped up, 32nd when it came to rushing yards before contact per attempt last year. Like, and you've got to get better than that.
Doug knows it. Doug told us at the combine, he was, you know, when he was questioned about Press Taylor and the state of the offense, he noted we were a top 10 passing offense, but yes, we were bottom 10, or he goes, actually, bottom three in rushing. Yeah. And so he, again,
but it's not ETN.
All I can tell you is Doug Peterson has now multiple times over said, I know the problems and I know how to fix them. And so until we see it on the field, that's just what I will defer to. Let's showcase, ladies, just how polarizing drafting a Florida Gator, and also Ricky Pearsall in particular, is. Off the text line, Design My Lifetime Enclosures, from 534, Pearsall is a cup type and he will crush it, akin to Cooper Cup. Then from 7-1, then from 451, Jags draft Pearsall and they can move to London. I'm sick of Gator pandering. It literally worked one time and we draft one every year. Sir, I am here to tell you that I am the least Gator panderer on the airwaves here at 1010XL. I just think Ricky Pearsall is actually a good player. And by the way, he started at Arizona State and he was a pretty darn good player there too.
Yeah. As did Jaden Daniels and Johnny Wilson.
And they all went on to have a pretty good college careers.
Absolutely. Yeah. Right, someone said no T-Rexes this year.
We've got a T-Rex, and he may or may not live in, there's one in Manhattan, Kansas, and there's another one in Tallahassee. We could get to that on the other side, can't we, Lauren?
We also have our Heels highlights coming up. You are listening to Helmets and Heels on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Through thick and thin.
I love my Jaguars.
Your home for Jaguars football.
Forever and ever and ever.
Is 1010XL.
Hey, sports fans, it's Hayes Carlion from MyBookie. Oh, it is here.
Masters Week, my favorite, Tiger's in the field. We've got the Live Golf guys playing in a major again. It is going to be a blast. If you haven't signed up for my bookie, you need to sign up. This is going to be must-see TV, and you can bet long odds for big golf sweats and even bigger cash. Outright winners, first-round leaders, and live betting too. I'm telling you, if you haven't signed up yet for my bookie, do it now for Masters Week. Could the weather in Augusta cause some chaos? Take advantage of that. Make some money. Even if the Masters has started, you can live bet with long odds through Sunday afternoon. Getting started is simple. Sign up today at MyBookie and use promo code 1010XL to secure a first deposit bonus up to 50%. It's simple. Just use promo code 1010XL to claim your 50% bonus, $50 minimum. Bet anything, anytime, anywhere with MyBookie.
Tired of dealing with clogged drains? What about those bad smells coming from your pipes? No matter how big or small your commercial or residential project may be, my friends at Duck Duck Rooter can handle it. Contact them today for all your plumbing, septic, and air conditioning needs at 904-862-6769. And while I have your attention, Duck Duck Rooter is also hiring plumbers. They offer excellent weekly pay, health insurance, paid holidays, 401k, and more. Apply now at duckduckrooter.com, and they will call you for an interview.
Have you been dreaming of enhancing your living space with top-quality custom windows and doors? Well, now's the 30-day spring sale with Renewal by Anderson. Save $300 on every window, $825 on all patio doors. Plus, no money down, no payments, and no interest for 12 months. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Renewal by Anderson, a better way to a better window. Visit rbafla.com.
License number CGC1527613.
Are you 18 years or older? Just got married? Just got divorced or have children? Listen up. Have you done your last will and estate planning? If you have questions, call Matt Hinson with the Hinson Law Firm. Reach him at 527-1700. Office is Jacksonville, Florida. And don't let the state decide your fate.
You don't have to be a football star to get a signing bonus. The team at Republic Services needs your skills, and they're paying up to $5,000 for you to join the roster. You'll be joining a winner. As an essential business, the Republic Services trucks have not stopped rolling with hourly and weekly pay and better benefits and vacation packages than the rest of the league. Driver trainees, $1,000 sign-on bonus. CDL drivers, $3,000. Diesel mechanics, $5,000 bonus. Join the winning team at Republic Services today. Visit republicservices.com.
Equal opportunity.
Mark Watson with Hardball Creative, with answers to the questions I'm asked the most. Yes, we are local, and no, I'm not hiring an actor to read these commercials. Check us out at hardballcreative.com.
Hardball Creative. Hardball does it all.
Don't just watch the position, learn the position.
Denny Thompson is the quarterback whisperer, and he knows.
We invite you into the lab so that you can truly learn the quarterback position.
Friday mornings on The Drill, brought to you by Tyson Sound and Security and George Moore Chevrolet on 1010XL.
Let's fire up the flavor and ignite those appetites. Let's slow down and smell the barbecue. Because all your favorites are smoked for hours and ready for eating when you are. From our famous ribs to slow smoked pork. Enjoy some perfection by the plateful, safely in our dining room or in the comfort of your home. With curbside pickup, drive-through, and delivery. Sonny's Barbecue, local pitmasters since 68.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free. No credit cards, no car loan, no personal loan. Hey, it's Prosser here, and Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make that happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. You can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards, get some money for a home improvement. Literally, hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508. 904-999-1508. That's loanpronto.com at 904-999-1508. NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
Why live with foot or ankle pain? If you have persistent pain, numbness, tingling, burning pain on the bottom of your foot, or swelling that doesn't improve with home treatment, it may be time to see Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute. Our foot and ankle specialists have innovative new options to help you get back in the swing of things without persistent pain that slows you down. Call JOI 2000 or go to joionline.net for an appointment.
Ever buy a gym membership but don't ever use it? Who hasn't? ET here, sports fans, and instead, I send plants and flowers to people I love from Kuhn Flowers, home of the beautiful window display on Beach Boulevard. Now that's money well spent. Kuhn Flowers.
Spring is here, and along with it comes the best golfing days of the year. Come out to Hidden Hills and test out our Arnold Palmer signature masterpiece and enjoy the popular Hills Grill after your round. Book your tee time today, HiddenHillsGC.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Later!
About who the Jaguars might draft with the 17th pick and certainly beyond that. One thing you just mentioned, though, Taylor, as we headed to break, no T-Rex this year?
Yeah.
Explain to people what you meant by that.
Yeah, go ahead, because you're this is how it all started, the T-Rex.
So for those who may be new to Helmets and Heels, but you listen to XL Primetime in its previous iteration from 12 to 3, you should still listen to it from 2 to 4, by the way.
Oh, show.
There was a conversation surrounding Aiden Hutchinson and his shorter arms. If you go through every Trent Baalke draft pick, and I'm not going to go through the actual numbers by position in terms of what a corner's length should be, mm-hmm. what a edge rusher's length should be, but the bottom line is that Trent Baalke values arm length mm-hmm. above all else. And so with Aiden Hutchinson and his makeup, the production that he had in college was great. He obviously came to Jacksonville on a visit. They did their due diligence in learning about him, learning about Trayvon Walker, ultimately made the decision to draft Trayvon, and some have likened that decision to the arm length. Mm-hmm. And so that is how I started discussing Aiden Hutchinson and referring to him as a T-Rex. And so one of our listeners, one of our Heligans, wanted to know if there are any T-Rexes in this year's class. The two that I would tell you, and for what it's worth, people I've spoken with within the organization really like both of these two players, but they understand the reality of the general manager and his preferred traits.
Yeah.
The two that I have specifically heard about are Cooper Beebe, the guard for Kansas State, who, again, like, great player. And I do not know if the Jaguars have actually had conversations with him, but I do know they believe he's a good player. But with the short arms, it's just the nature of how the organization works, and that has been accepted by many, that as good of a player as he is, unless the value meets where they have him ranked, they're probably not going with our short-armed friend, Cooper Beebe. Ditto to... Don't come for me, Noles fans. Braden Fisk, who we know is undersized. We know the measurables are not there, but he tested off the charts at the combine.
What a great combine.
Again, it's not saying the Jaguars don't believe these players are good players. They believed Aiden Hutchinson was a good player, but Trent Baalke, with his 20-plus, 30-plus years in the league and scouting and then being a general manager, this is what he values, and so I'm sorry if it offends you that I refer to such players as T-Rexes, but he will never be drafting T-Rexes unless the value meets the need further down the line.
I feel like some might have thought we were talking about the Kalavon workout.
We're not talking about Kalavon.
I remember last year the one we talked, Peter Skoronski was one of the ones we talked a lot about, the short arm thing, and you saw it a ton early. He definitely had a good that last game against the Titans, he played really, really well, actually, against the Jags. But earlier in the season, you saw him get it. I mean, it was looking rough for a minute. And I'm like, his little baby arms can't do it.
I'm actually glad we brought up arm length because I will direct us once again to Mia's Mock Draft 2.0, now available on 1010XL.com. And the third round selection by your Jaguars, Taylor.
Oh.
I know we had you getting ready to pour a glass of something when I made the decision.
Vodka Kool-Aid.
probably some Kool-Aid with some Everclear or something in it. Don't drink that, kids. Personal experience. But what I know your concern was the Jaguars trading back to acquire draft capital. Mm-hmm. You can't guarantee you will be able to trade back up. Well, I live in an idealistic world when I make mock drafts, but I also think this has some legs to it. Mm-hmm. Could be reality. I have the Jaguars with the ammo that they got from the Tampa Bay Buccaneers in this simulation in which they traded back to number 26, taking number 89, one of their fourth-round picks, number 114, as well as their sixth-round pick, 212, and going up to 75 to select Austin Booker, edge rusher out of Kansas, who, as luck would have it, 6'4 and a half inches tall, 33 and 7/8 inch length arms. That was the third best at the NFL Combine. He, much like Trayvon Walker, only started one game in college. He transferred from Minnesota to Kansas. But at the same time...
So this is one of those project guys you were talking about.
Yes. Lance Zierlein of NFL.com, a former employer, of course, of our good friend RJ Saunders, our producer extraordinaire. Lance Zierlein's comp for Austin Booker is Max Crosby.
Ooh.
Lance Zierlein didn't just get in the game of this. He has been grinding tape and studying prospects for decades.
Yeah.
And the fact that he went out on the limb and said that his comp, his ceiling, could be Max Crosby, that says to me, especially knowing how thin this edge rusher class is, you do everything you possibly can to get that kid, knowing what the general manager here in Jacksonville values. And knowing that you have Trayvon Walker and Josh Allen and Travis Gibson, and so... he wouldn't be asked to be Max Crosby day one here in Jacksonville.
Yeah, yeah. I've heard the Max Crosby comp to Braylon Trice, too.
Yes and no. I think Braylon Trice, who I love, by the way, I think he's a great player. I think in terms of ceiling, it'll be the same conversation many have about Michael Penix Jr., his former teammate at Washington, where what we are seeing is elite, and it will translate to the league. But is that the ceiling?
Yeah, yeah.
Not to mention with Braylon Trice cutting nearly 30 pounds to test off the charts at the combine, we know he's not actually going to play at that weight.
Yeah.
And so I believe he's a good player, and he's another one of those who, like Aiden Hutchinson, quite frankly, in a different light, obviously, but you know you're going to get production out of him.
Yeah.
Where the ceiling lies because of the natural God-given measurables, that's where teams may have questions as far as how far can he actually go with his development?
Yeah.
If you're telling me we get a good receiver like a Brian Thomas Jr. with the 17th pick, if the Jaguars stay put, with the 48th pick, you get one of the corners that's still on the board, and then you get an edge rusher that turns out to be anything like Max
Close to
Crosby.
Max Crosby. Right.
I am signing on the dotted line for
and
that
by the way,
right
the
now.
Jags in this scenario, again, you can find it at 1010XL.com. In this scenario, they would maintain the 92nd overall pick they got from the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, and I have them selecting Mekhi Wingo, defensive tackle out of LSU, a reunion with Matt House's former defense coordinator, now the inside linebackers coach here in Jacksonville. And much like his running mate Mason Smith, it is going to be fascinating to see where these two players and so many on that LSU defense are drafted, because we know the production was certainly not there the way that many people thought it would be for LSU this past fall, and how many yards they gave up and how many touchdowns they gave up. But you cannot deny, again, the measurables and the production, I think, that both those players had in flashes, if you may. And so Mekhi Wingo, 6 foot, so undersized, 284, but he can play multiple positions. He was the SEC's top-rated defensive tackle in terms of run defensive grade, according to PFF. So he would be great at stopping the run. He can get after the quarterback as well. And I think the biggest thing is that he would provide some much-needed depth behind Arik Armstead and can play the 3 or the 5 technique.
Sounds good. We've got our heel highlights.
That's good.
Heel lights. Also on the other side, one segment to go here on Helmets and Heels on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Get a Gator baseball chomp on 1010XL.
It's the battle of state powerhouses. Florida, Florida State. Tonight at 6 on 1010 AM.
Prosser here. When it comes to the business of selling your home, there's one promise I can give you that will deliver, and that promise is ChadAndSandy.com. That's ChadAndSandy.com. How do I know this promise is guaranteed? Because they say so, and then they deliver. You see, Chad and Sandy guarantee your home sold at an agreed-upon price and deadline, or they will buy it. So whatever problems you think you're having selling your home, there is your simple solution. They're going to buy it if it's not sold for exactly what you want. Mortgage rates have lowered going into the spring selling season. Now is the time to maximize your equity, and you can do it with the real estate team of Chad and Sandy. They have a plan and the experience to sell your home fast for maximum cash this spring. John and Ursula in Green Meadows wrote in, we weren't in great health, decided to downsize to an easier place to manage. After 185 days, our home failed to sell. We went to Chad and Sandy, sold in 12 days. You can too at chadandsandy.com.
Four! Oh boy, the Masters is here. Tiger is in the field. He even met with reporters this morning. And some of those LIV Golf guys are back at the majors. Mia here, and if you haven't signed up for MyBookie, you need to sign up for Masters Week. This is going to be must-see TV, and you can bet long odds for big golf sweats and even bigger cash. Outright winners, first-round leaders, live betting too. Could the weather in Augusta cause some chaos? Take advantage of that and make some money. Even if the Masters has started, you could still live bet with long odds through Sunday afternoon. Getting started is simple. Sign up today at MyBookie and use promo code 1010XL to secure a first deposit bonus up 50%. It's simple. Just use promo code 1010XL to claim your 50% bonus, $50 minimum. This is one of the most fun betting weeks of the year, and you can hit winners for long odds. Promo code 1010XL. Bet with MyBookie.
If you're an experienced, skilled plumber or welder that's MedGas certified and you're tired of working for a company that just doesn't treat you right, Local 234 is the place for you. Their pay is the best in the business. You'll walk away with $35.09 an hour in your pocket with benefits that's just over $50 an hour. Local 234 has been around since 1901, and that means something. Visit ua234.com to send your resume. Local 234, make the right connection.
Hey there, all you sports dads rocking the best dad bod possible. We love seeing you eat tacos by the handful, and we love it when you bring your kids here too. For years, Lucy claimed that her favorite thing on the menu was sopapillas, the big scoop of ice cream. I know that's not a taco, but that never stopped her. I was shooting for dad of the year anyway, so I just let it happen. Taco Lou is a great place to bring the family. There's something for everyone, as long as it starts with a taco. And a margarita for mom is always a good thing. At Taco Lou in Jacksonville Beach.
It's the Googan Open.
I got to learn how to play golf.
For a chance for you and a partner to play in this year's Coastal Equipment Googan Golf Open, April 15th at Hidden Hills Golf Club, listen to Dan and Jeff on the drill. Enjoy a Chick-fil-A breakfast and a Dandy Foods lunch.
Put the ball in a hole.
Score a hole-in-one, and you could win $500 cash from Lucas Honda.
Yeah!
You could also win a Bernie Grill from Stone Core. Pictures from Jack Sports Photography. Thanks to our sponsors, Southeast Orthopedic Specialist, Ahead, and Ackerman Urology.
Divorce, menonly.com. This is Kenny Lay of Kenny Lay & Associates. Our firm specializes in representing men in family law. That's all we do. That's our only focus. We can help with all of your family law needs, such as divorce, custody, alimony, and child support. For over a decade, we have helped thousands of men with these types of issues. We even have an appellate division ready to challenge a judge's ruling. If you need a family law attorney, go to divorcemenonly.com. Divorcemenonly.com. Offices, Jacksonville.
Mia here. Looking to spruce up your home or business for the spring? Window Gang's exterior cleaning services will remove stubborn stains, restore windows to a clear shine, and ensure your gutters flow freely. Call 262-7300 for a free estimate.
David here with Royal Pest Services. Man, don't let your yard be torn up by that heavy aeration machine this spring. Visit royalpestservices.com to learn more about our granular aeration. Broadcast throughout the tree and shrubs to break up that compacted soil. Visit royalpestservices.com.
A tradition unlike any other.
Rays Creek, Butler Cabin, and the Green Jacket.
Ready to rip it.
The Masters.
That's a beauty.
Masters coverage on 1010XL is brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
Lauren Brooks here for Hodges Mazda. Why buy from Hodges Mazda at the Avenues? Because they strive to ensure a satisfying and comfortable car buying experience. That's why the sales staff doesn't work on commission, allowing Hodges Mazda to put your best interest first. Whether you're looking for a brand new Mazda or a pre-owned vehicle, Hodges Mazda has a large selection to help you choose from. And every vehicle purchase from Hodges Mazda comes with 2 years free maintenance and free car washes for life. Now that is peace of mind. So visit Hodges Mazda today or shop online at HodgesMazda.com.
An ACL tear can be a devastating injury with prolonged pain and rehabilitation. Hi, I'm Dr. George Bari. I'm a sports medicine orthopedic surgeon who grew up right here in Jacksonville and then went on to train with the world-renowned Dr. James Andrews. At Bari Orthopedics, we use the most current techniques to get you back on the field with less pain and quicker rehabilitation. We treat all types of sports injuries with the newest techniques available. Please call us for consultation or visit BariOrthopedics.com.
Find out more at BariOrthopedics.com. That's B-A-H-R-I Orthopedics.com.
American Electrical is looking for bright minds and hard workers to help light up North Florida. This community continues to grow, and now you can grow your career with a company that will make sure you succeed through commitment. American Electrical even has its own academy dedicated to training select students the electrical trade, and the best news, it's free of charge. Log on to American-Electrical.com to find out more. They're leading the way in electrical contractors on the First Coast. American-Electrical.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
On Tuesdays, we unveil our highlights from the week. Mia O'Brien, Taylor Dahl. I'm Lauren Brooks, RJ Saunders, making it all happen. And thanks to our guests who joined us earlier today, Timeless Tony Storm from AEW. They'll be at Daly's Place April 24th and April 27th. You can get your tickets at Daly'sPlace.com. As well as Shannon Farron from Los Angeles, who joined us on the Chargers pick. All right, let's get it to this week's highlights, ladies.
Jack Caglione's 15th home run gives Florida a 3-2 lead over Missouri.
Swing and a deep drive, right field, way back, and Jack Caglione gives Florida the lead. 15th home run of the season, his 8th in his last 11 games, and the Gators break through to lead it 3-2 in the 6th.
Michael Busch lays out to secure the W against his former team.
Swing and a liner, caught! Lays out, Cubs win.
No need for a national championship. Ian Eagle with the call of the tournament on Grant Nelson's poster jam in the Final Four.
Nelson attacking. Oh, we just got the full Nelson on a major wreck attack.
The Orlando Magic are the 3 seed in the Eastern Conference. Play the song. Orlando Magic, oh.
Give to Ben Carroll, and that's why he got down low and he dunked it down with 2 hands. A thunder dunk from Seattle's finest.
RJ, I think I need you to sing the Orlando Magic song. I can't just listen to the AI bot say it. Go, RJ.
Orlando Magic. Oh.
Well done, and that was a thunder dunk for sure.
Oh, no, that wasn't a thunder dunk. That was a rack attack, a major rack attack. We also had a wedgie in the Alabama-UConn semifinal game on Saturday, too. We literally were playing all the hits for my mentor, Ian Eagle, who will be joining us at some point in the next few weeks after he recovers from his first first Final Four. Oh, and by the way, he gets thrown right back into the fire and has to go back to calling Nets games and NBA games. So
it never stops when you work in sports. It never stops. And Taylor, you had a Cubs win?
I did. The Cubs took 2 of 3. They blew a lead last night, so I'm not talking about that one. I went to bed. It was a West Coast game, so it started at like way too late, just like the basketball game. But I went to bed. It was 8-0. I wake up and they lost, and I'm like, what the heck happened? But so we're going back to taking 2 of 3 against the Dodgers, and Michael Busch, who that highlight was about, we got from the Dodgers in a trade. It was one of their prospects, and so we just got him this offseason, and he crushed them this series, like in his return against his former team, was just every single game, whether it was making some crazy fielding play on first base or hitting a home run or launching one to left field for a triple, one thing after another. So it was really fun to watch that. And obviously take 2 of 3 against the Dodgers, who everyone and watching Shohei Ohtani get struck out a few times.
Yes, that is always fun. And my highlight was from Jack Caglione's 15th home run. Florida got swept by Missouri. So, like, to your point, Taylor, not going to talk about the actual series, but Cags is still playing well as far as offensively. He struggled a little bit at the mound on Sunday.
Some other news and notes that we want to relay to you guys. First and foremost, from Matt Norlander, one of the most respected sources at CBS Sports, the very latest on John Calipari, ladies. After we got off the air yesterday, you may have seen the viral video of him walking his dog and his dog's stroller down Richmond Road, which for those of you not familiar with Lexington, Kentucky, is one of the most preeminent road. I would equate it to like the San Pablo, if you may, the San Pablo, like that road or Hodges. Like I would say it's one of those in terms of traffic. Anyways, I say that to say John Calipari is out here front and center for cameras as the most famous person to reside in the state of Kentucky, even though he's allegedly trying to leave. According to Matt Norlander, as of this moment, Calipari has not had any contact with Kentucky Athletic Director Mitch Barnhart. He is waiting on approval for his Arkansas contract, which could happen any hour now, before finalizing the divorce with Kentucky. Additionally, Barnhart is not formally moving ahead with UK's coaching search until word is final on Calipari, even if it's inevitable right now. He is waiting for that before he personally makes contact with candidates and agents. And also, before we go,
can I just on that same David Kaplan, ESPN 1000 in Chicago, just reported also that he doesn't believe Bulls coach Billy Donovan is at all interested in the
that
job at Kentucky.
And Norlander, and it was funny, I think the same text was sent to multiple national reporters of Billy Donovan is, quote, locked in on the Chicago Bulls. So there's,
like I said yesterday, I don't think that Billy Donovan wants to leave the NBA unless
he would be leaving at midseason too. I mean, I know it's the end of the year, but still.
But to go to a college world where it is college basketball, college
wild
football,
right now,
it is it's insane when it comes to all those NIL.
As I said yesterday, Lauren, he's already got too many gray hairs from coaching the Bulls. How many would he have from being the governor of Kentucky? And finally, to put a bow on Chargers Day here on Helmets and Heels, as we did have Shannon from KFIR, yes, I believe that's the right acronym.
Yeah, Gary and Shannon.
Yes, from Southern California. We're going to put a bow on the Jim Harbaugh discussion. According to Dan with LA Football Network and 1090 ESPN, I believe this is real. I hope it's not. Jim Harbaugh has made some locker room changes. Not only are players' lockers rearranged numerically, but each player nameplate now shows their recruiting level coming out of high school. We're going to do some digging, but this guy looks like he's a legit reporter.
Why would you do that in an NFL locker room?
So yeah, weird. I'm fascinated. I am fascinated.
Get all those star ratings for their fullbacks they've added into their roster.
Yeah, those stories I feel like are going to start coming out almost daily as we get closer to the season as far as crazy things that he does during OTAs, Harbaugh that is.
Yeah, he doesn't eat chicken because, what did she say?
Because it's a nervous animal. Maybe that's my problem since I get so nervous because I eat a lot of chicken.
Before your next flight, do not eat chicken.
That is correct. That's going to do it for us today. Once again, as always, thank you to RJ Saunders. And for Mia O'Brien, for Taylor Dahl, and Lauren Brooks, don't go anywhere. XL Primetime comes up next. These heels are made for talking. We'll talk to you tomorrow.